Hare Krishna. To get out of the mind, go above it to the soul, or go below it to the body. The mind is a deadly enemy. The mind can delude and degrade us with no limits to how much it can delude and degrade us. And when we get caught in our mind, it can become like a stormy wind which drags us far away. So when we get getting caught in our mind's delusions, we need to get out of it. Our existence is three level: body, mind and soul. So if say there is a fire at the second level in a building, to get out of it, we could either go to the third level or we could go to the first level. So similarly, when we want to get out of the mind, we can either go above it to the soul or we can go below it to the body. So the idea is that sometimes when we are too lost in our head, we might go out for a walk, we might do a workout, we might just do some deep breathing, and all these can calm our mind. So get out of the mind and we come down to the level of the body. Now, of course, at the level of the body also, sometimes we can experience a lot of agitation, temptation, tribulation. And coming to the level of the body is not a sustainable solution. But it can be a starting solution, it can be an initial and powerful solution initially. So the other is that we get out of the mind and go to the level of the soul. That means we raise our consciousness to the spiritual level through mantra chanting, through philosophical contemplation, through devotional meditation on the supreme spiritual reality, Krishna. And either way, we can get out of our mind. So we need to know that the mind is a formidable enemy and we can't have a one-track formula for dealing with the mind. We need to be resourceful and have an array of weapons, various strategies for going either up or going below. And thus, we can deal with the mind. So this twofold approach for dealing with the mind is indicated in the sixth chapter of the Bhagavad-Gita, wherein initially external physical objects for focusing the mind are talked about, and then eventually inner absorption is recommended. Say, for example, in 6.13 and 14, it is said, Samam kaya shiro grivam dharayana chalam sthiraha samprekshana sikagram sam dishaschanavalokayan prashantatma vigatabhir brahmachari vratesthitaha manasayam yamachitto yuktasita matparaha. So samam kaya shiro grivam, sit steadily with the body in one line, and samprekshana sikagram swam. So here the idea is, previously it has been said, go to a secluded place, sit where there will not be any distractions, there will be calm atmosphere, and then focus on the tip of the nose. Elsewhere it is said, focus on the space between the eyebrows. Either way, the idea is focus on something that enables us to grow, to take our consciousness out of our mind. So here, the tip of the nose or the space between the eyebrows, these are physical points of concentration. The idea is get your thoughts out of the mind to the level of the body. And then prashantatma, as the mind becomes peaceful, then we meditate on our spiritual indestructible identity, and then vigatabhir. And then that which drags us to outer sensual level, give it up. Brahmachari vratesthita. Start practicing sensual abstinence. And then manasayamya machitto yuktasita matparaha. Then fix, regulate the mind and focus it on the higher supreme reality, that is Krishna himself. So thus, by getting our thoughts, getting our consciousness out of our mind, and going wherever is easily accessible, and eventually raising it to the spiritual level, we all can learn to discipline our mind and make our life meaningful and fruitful. Thank you. Hare Krishna.